God! Michael, what did you do?
My name is Todd May. I teach philosophy at Clemson University. I've been teaching philosophy for about 30 years. The utilitarian philosophy goes back a couple hundred years. Probably the first person really associated with it is an 18th century thinker named Jeremy Bentham. Then it goes up through John Stuart Mill, and it's still very big in philosophy.
Cool.
It's all about the consequences of what you do. It's not about what you intend. It's not about following rules. It's about whatever your action is, right? The world should be a little bit better off when you're done with that action than when you started. For Bentham, it's all a matter of introducing more pleasure into the world than was there before. It's all a matter of suffering and pleasure.
Huh.
The problem is, for a lot of folks, it isn't just about how much pleasure you can get. Let's suppose that I could design a pleasure machine for you. You go into the machine, you'll feel nothing but pleasure for the rest of your life. You won't be doing anything, but it's gonna feel great. Here's the proviso. If you go into that machine, you can't come back out. You have to decide once and for all, would you take the machine? And not many people would take it.
Really? Huh.
When I teach in prisons, one of my classes is a group of lifers, right? They're not going anywhere. They're gonna be in that maximum security prison for the rest of their lives. And I posed the question to them. I had 15 people. And I said, would you take that machine? 14 of them said no, right? Because for all of them, there has to be more to life than just generating pleasure.
This is so interesting.
You can think of utilitarians as not necessarily being about pleasure. We can think, say, of happiness, right, as a broader category. What binds all these together is that for the utilitarian, it's the consequences that count, right? It's not how you get there, it's where you wind up.
I think I'm really starting to get it.
The trolley problem is one of the classic places where people think about utilitarianism and think about whether or not we ought to be utilitarian.
You are driving a trolley, and on the track ahead of you are five workmen that you will run over. Now, you can steer to another track, but on that track is one person you would kill instead of the five. What do you do?
Some people think of the trolley problem as a way of defending utilitarianism. Look, if you gotta kill one person to save five, that's what you ought to do. So, remember in one scene, Achilles running the trolley.
There are five workers on this track and one over there. Make a choice.
Quick, Judy, what's your decision?
I am choosing to switch tracks, so that way I only kill one person.
In some ways, and the show brings this out, it's a way of illustrating some of the problems of utilitarianism. In another scene, which comes from philosophy, instead of running over one person to save five, the question is, do you find a healthy person and carve them up in order to use their organs, each one for a different operation?
Dude, what the fork?
These five people all need organ transplants or they will die. Eleanor's perfectly healthy. Chidi, do you want to slice her open and use her organs to save the five sick people?
People who are willing to throw the switch to kill the one to save the five in the trolley problem generally are not going to say, yeah, it's okay to go out in the street and kill one person in order to harvest their organs to save five other lives.
Although five people will die, I cannot harm one innocent person to save them. It's unethical.
But then the question becomes, what's the difference? Utilitarian's going to say, it's the same problem, should have the same answer. But right, what Chidi begins to recognize in that actually may not be the same problem for reasons that are difficult to say. One seems obvious to do and the other seems obvious not to do. And for Chidi, this becomes a very difficult thing to sort out.
Oh, come on!
For Jason, I guess the question is, what would Blake Bortles do?
Jacksonville Jaguars rule!
But for Chidi, he's got to think philosophically about this.
Why don't you just tell me the right answer?
I would say that there may be contradictory right answers. That is to say, it's probably at least okay and maybe right to throw the switch. And it's not okay to carve up the one to save the five. But if you ask me, yeah, what's the difference? I don't know what to tell you.
Well, that's good.